Please stand up. If you, it's your question.
Sorry,
right.
Sir.
Right. Thank you. Let the answer be
sorry,
given.
Sorry, sir. Sir, I am empowered
aap
committee
sawal
of poochye,
ab poochye sawal. Now, please ask your question.
Sir, an empowered committee of secretaries in 2007 recommended for revival of Ramagundam urea and fertilizer plant in Telangana during Congress government, sir. And even after 9 years, still foundation stone was not laid for starting its revival, sir. Second week of January this year was set as moved to lay the foundation stone by PM, but it has not been done. Now, again, on 7th of this month, Prime Minister is going to lay the foundation stone, but I am not able to understand when it will be completed. Second thing, sir.
What is your question?
I am putting, sir. Sir, a total of 3,000 casual labour and 450 permanent ones can be created in the unit once revived. The casual labour working earlier was removed as this plant was shut. Now there is a demand that it is a genuine one that the government must reappoint removed workers once plant becomes operational. This is also the demand of the
आपका सवाल क्या है?
सर, पूछ रहा हूँ सर.
नहीं नहीं भाषण मत दीजिए.
मैं बोल रहा हूँ सर मैं. So, will the Honorable Minister assure on this house that he would reappoint all the workers who were removed from the Ramagundam plant, and if not, the reasons may be given, and
thank
when
you.
This plant will be commissioned.
Thank you. Let us.
There is a good news, sir, for Honorable Member Govardhan Reddy Garu, as well as the entire people of Telangana. It was the decision was taken long back in 2007, but we started the entire process in 2014 after our Honorable Prime Minister gave a vision of making India self-reliant in urea production, and therefore we also decided that we should proceed with the revival of Ramagundam project. Actually, the NFL is having 26% of equity share. Engineers India Limited will have 26% of equity share. SBI Cap, we are having talks with them to have 11% of equity share. And Government of Telangana is also contemplating of having 11% of equity share. And because of this atmosphere and support, I think we will proceed with the foundation laying ceremony of Ramagundam very soon, and I assure within 36 months the fertilizer plant will be ready with an investment of 6,000 crore rupees, and it will be producing 13 lakh metric tons of urea, which will be a great bonanza for the people of Telangana and the southern parts of India.
Thank you. Dusra prashn.
And has not come, sir, regarding the labour. I ask the minister has not given any reply, sir.
Whether they will be taken there.
Sir, the management, the joint venture partners, the JVP that has been formed will take all administrative decisions. Of course, it is going to generate lot of employment, direct and indirect. Together, there will be employment for not less than 4,000 people, sir, at different levels in different ways.
थैंक यू श्री प्रेमचंद गुप्ता. अरे हो गया, यही तो सेकंड क्वेश्चन. नहीं नहीं भाई, आप दो बार वही सवाल नहीं पूछ सकते हैं.
भाई देयरफॉर साहब, दूसरी साहब,
अच्छा बैठ जाइए भाई, सुन लीजिए.
सर, मैं सप्लीमेंट्री इज रिलेटिंग टू पार्ट डी ऑफ द मेन क्वेश्चन सर, व्हिच टॉक्स अबाउट रिवाइवल ऑफ रामगुंडम दैट प्रोड्यूसेस यूरिया एंड फर्टिलाइजर सर. Sir, the government announced a reduction in the price of DAP, MOP, and NPK, and farmers felt very happy and thought that they would get fertilizers at a cheaper rate. But when they have gone to dealers, they found there is no change in the price of fertilizers. Rather, they have gone up little.
Part D relates to expected capacity. not to the price.
Sir, I want to answer this question, sir, with your permission.
Yeah, okay. Sir, sir, actually, sir, I have not asked full question, sir.
अरे भाई आप कितना समय लेंगे? आपने कहा पार्ट डी रिलेट्स टू एक्सपेक्टेड कैपेसिटी.
चांस सर, आई हैव नॉट टोल्ड कंप्लीट, आई हैव नॉट आस्क्ड कंप्लीट क्वेश्चन सर. हियर द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट द डिसीजन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली ऑन टू पीएसयूज ऑफ आरसीएफ एंड एनएफएल. दोज मार्केट शेयर इज लेस देन 5%. 95% is controlled by private fertilizer
companies. What is the question?
I'm putting, sir. Hence, I would like to know from the Honorable Minister, will the direct the private companies to reduce prices of fertilizers as announced by the government recently? If not, the reasons may be given. Thank you.
Sir, with your permission, actually there is another good news for the farmers of this country. Actually, after 30 years...
You are encouraging the Honorable Minister to ask more unrelated questions.
I said, sir, with your permission only, because there should not be any apprehension in the minds of the farmers as well as people of India, that in 1977, Chaudhary Charan Singh Saab had reduced the price of urea by 30 rupees, and later, no government could reduce the prices of fertilizers. First time under the leadership of Narendra Modi, recently on 5th of July, we have reduced the rates of DAP, MOP and NPK fertilizers, sir, to the tune of 2,500 rupees per ton of DAP, that is 125 rupees per 50 kgs bag, and 5,000 rupees for 1 ton of MOP, that is 250 rupees per 50 kg bag, and for NPK, jisko mishrik khad kehte hai, for NPK we have reduced 1000 rupees, that is 50 rupees per 50 kg bag, sir. But the thing is, sir, ultimately this Essential Commodities Act that comes at the implementation at the level of the state governments. Therefore, I have requested personally, by sending letters to all the chief ministers of the various states, that they should enforce EC, they should also do siege and search and other activities, so that every retailer, every dealer in the country, fertilizer dealer and retailer, will follow this MRP only.
Thank you.
Because all the manufacturing companies, sir, all the manufacturing companies, not only two public CPSUs, everybody has given an assurance to the undertaking to the Government of India, Fertilizer Ministry, this is the direction of rate, MRP of DAP, MOP and NPK. We only expect, sir, because of this gift to the farmers, there is a good monsoon, we want a super harvest.
Thank you.
Super fasal for the farmers.
Thank you.